In this week's episode of my Working with Todoist series, I'm going to show you all the new features related to Todoist sections, or rather project sections. Now, what Todoist are doing is they are rolling out more and more features related to sections. So this week what we got was a new feature where you could actually use the forward slash key to be able to quickly add tasks to the relevant section when you're adding tasks to Todoist. And I thought, well, while I'm showing you how this feature works, what I would do is I would show you all the features that you can use, all the quick add syntax that you can use in order to quickly get your tasks into the right place in your Todoist. Now, before we go any further, what I would like to do is to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my Todoist and I'll show you all you need to know about the new features related to sections. Right, okay, so what we have here is my This Week folder. So if you are following the time sector system, you will have a section in This Week called Recurring Areas of Focus. Now, it's up to you if you have other projects, but this is how mine is set up. So I have this section here. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take you through a few of the things that you can do as you're setting up a task. So the first thing is we're going to go, this is a task. I'm just going to keep it simple. Now, the first thing you can do is you can type in the date. So if I type in M for Monday, M-O-N for Monday, it will come up Monday. If I hit space, I can now type P2, which will give me the orange or yellow, orange flag. I can then type the hashtag and I can type in this week and tap return. And now what I can do is add a forward slash and it will bring up the recurring areas of focus. So I can just tap on that. And now what I've essentially done is I have given it a date. I've put in a flag, a priority. I have a project and I have a section within that project. Now, obviously, if you have more than one section, all those sections will show up. Another thing you can do actually is type at and you can then get access to your labels as well. So essentially, without leaving the keyboard, without having to use your mouse, essentially, you can quickly add tasks. All I need to do now is hit return. And that task has gone in. So if we go into this week, what I've got here is, this is a task, which is right here. It's got, let's open up the actual task. So you can see it's gone into this week's project. It's got a date, it's got a priority, and it's gone into the right, it's got the right label. And by the way, I can tap that from here and go straight to the actual label itself. So it really does speed things up if you're using labels. Let's go back to this week here. And this is a task. I'll click on that to go into the view. And I can change the date by hitting this here. And I can go in there and it will open up the date picker. And I can, of course, change the flag by just tapping on that. And I can go in here and change it. So you can change it at any time. You can do whatever you want within the task. And this is one of those ways that Todoist are working sort of behind the scenes to help you to speed up the way that we are adding tasks. And really, one of the things that I strongly advocate is that whenever you're adding a task, if you know where it's going to go, and this is something that I do, if I have a task that I know it needs to be done this week, I can quickly add the task, whether I'm on my mobile device or on my on this computer, which is often where I'm doing it. So this is a new task. And I can add this in and I just go and type in the hashtag and I can type in next week and it will be adding to next week's project. Now, while we're here, what you'll also notice is now that Todoist has changed the quick entry. So while you're adding a task, you can, if you like to use your mouse, you can hit the schedule here and it will bring up your your date picker, and I can change the project very quickly by moving, oh, I need to do that this week, so I can quickly add it in here. And you'll also notice that sections have their own icon now, so you can actually see the sections. And so although last week I did a video on how to get the adding the subprojects view here, adding that in, what Todoist really wants us to do now is to move towards sections, and they're making it easier to add in there so you can actually build sections into your filters as well, which is really, really good. So over time, we're going to have a better way of managing the whole projects and the way that our projects are viewed and seen within the project window itself. To me, it just makes your project list on the left-hand side a much cleaner experience. And when something is cleaner, you're going to find that you're going to use it a lot more. I think it's not going to be long before I actually start using this. I have sub-projects here for routines because it's something I've always done. As I mentioned last week, now when I hit the main parent folder, I can't see it, but I will over the next few weeks no doubt move these to sections because it just makes life so much easier. So if I wanted to add a new routine, so take dog for a walk, I can do the add routines, and then I can hit forward, and I don't have sections in there. But if I created a sections called daily, it's going to ask create daily. So I'm going to create daily, which I've now done. So I've got the section created, and I'm going to type in every day, and that's done. Hit that. If I go into my routines, as you can see here, I now have a new section. So you can add sections directly from when you add the task. So there you go. That's just a few of the new things that have been coming out of Todoist. Todoist are doing a lot of work in the background, and I think a lot of it is not being noticed, because these are subtle changes that are just making Todoist that much better. So if you've got all these sub projects that I have here, routines, then perhaps it's now time to turn those into sections, those sub projects into sections, because Todoist are adding support almost on a weekly basis now to help you. So there you go. That's what I wanted to show you this week. So you've got a few ways that you can actually quickly add tasks. You can add all the data without leaving your keyboard and picking up the mouse. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.